صلى الله عليك يا مولاي يا رسول الله صلى الله عليك أيها البشير النذير والسراج المنير السلام عليك يا سيدي وعلى ابنك المظلوم الشهيد أبا عبد الله الحسين السلام عليك يا أبا عبد الله السلام عليك وعلى أخيك أبو الفضل العباس المقطوع الجفان المسهم بالعين السلام عليك يا مولاي أنعم بشبل المرتضى مكرم سفينة الإله وأحمد المختار عضد الحسين عضد الحسين بأبي الفضائل هو التقى عباس المندوب في الأخطار من جرحه المفتوح فجر أنهار جرفت قلاع الشرك والإنكار وسكبه وبكفيه وبكفه المبتور خط حكاية وملا حمال الجود والإيثار ووراسه المرفوع فوق القناة فوق الرمح قد أعلى مقام النبل في الأمصار وبسيفه قد هد أركان العداء وبسيفه قد هد أركان العدا ومعاقل الظلم والكفار لهفي عليه بكربلاء وقد دنت منه العقيلة تستقيل الصغار والنهر تحجبه المخاطر فالعداء قطعوا السبيل إلى الفرات الجاري فاسأل صارمه ويمم وجهه نحو الشريعة من عساه يباري احترق قلبي بسعيرك واتهابك وترك الناس كلها والتهابك شنو السبب روحي التجي لك والتهاب اكتهاب اكتفارك وتشيف لي ربي ليألف يم القمر عباس صوت الوان من زينب صيح من الخيم بالنوح يا بدر شلون تتغير بعظيم الحس روى الآلام صاحت زينب تنادي رهينة بوحشه الأحزان وقع بيتي هو أسنادي صرت بيني محن وهموم انطم وانتبع يا ما يمضي يا الآمال ما ريدن بعد شراب آه يا زينب آه يا زينب آه يا زينب آه آه يا زينب آه يا زينب إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون وسيعلم الذين ظلموا أهل بيت محمد بأي منقلب ينقلبون والعاقبة للمتقين صلوا على محمد وآل محمد
اللهم صل على محمد وآل
محمد لك تليفون
هيك مش عم تسمع
ها
That's okay. It's good. Yeah. Too late. Brothers and sisters, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Inshallah, tonight's lecture is going to be short and get straight to the maqtal of Abu Fadl Abbas alayhi salam. After the martyrdom of Sayyidah Zahra alayhi salam, Imam Ali alayhi salam, having not married anyone whilst being married to Sayyidah Zahra, Imam Ali married a woman by the name of Fatima bint Huzam al-Amriya, also known as Umm al-Banin.
Can you put this up a bit, please?
Imam Ali alayhi salam married a woman by the name of Fatima bint Huzam al-Amriya, known as Umm al-Banin. She had four sons, Abdullah, Uthman, Ja'far, and Abbas. Sayyidah Zahra alayhi salam, before she was martyred, she told Imam Ali alayhi salam, she told him, Ya Ali, you're going to have to get married after me. Although you're never going to be married to anyone whilst I'm alive, besides me. After me, you're going to get married. And I want you to marry this woman. So she told Imam Ali alayhi salam who she is. And it was Fatima bint Huzam. And she told him the characteristics of this woman. Irhamakumullah. And she told him also what this woman's going to do for your children. So Imam Ali alayhi salam, as soon as after a couple of months after Sayyidah Zahra alayhi salam passes or stashed, she's martyred, because he wants to fill that will of Sayyidah Zahra alayhi salam, so he goes and he marries Umm al-Banin. Umm al-Banin was known for her love for Ahlul Bayt, number one. She was also known for her iman, her faith, her respect for Ahlul Bayt, her respect for Imam Ali alayhi salam, her respect and her love for Sayyidah Zahra alayhi salam. She was known for this. So when she brought up her sons and she brought up her children, she brought them up on that basis to love Ali ibn Abi Talib, to respect Ali ibn Abi Talib, to love Imam Hussein, to respect Imam Hussein. Where in some narrations, to the extent where Imam Ali alayhi salam, every time he'd call Umm al-Banin by her name Fatima, a teardrop will come down in some narrations of Imam Ali alayhi salam. And that's why she changed the name to Umm al-Banin, because she saw that Imam Ali alayhi salam, my husband, every single time he calls my name Fatima, he remembers Fatima, his wife, he remembers Fatima, the daughter of Rasulullah. So he teardrops comes down. becomes to cry, starts to cry. So she told him, Ya Ali, please stop calling me by my first name. Call me by Ummul Baneen. Out of respect. Out of respect for Muhammad alayhi salam. Out of respect for Sayyidina Zahra and the love she had. So she brought up her children in that manner as well, to love Ahlul Bayt, to love Muhammad alayhi salam. She taught Abbas alayhi salam to respect Imam Hussein alayhi salam, to love him to the extent where Abu Fadl Abbas in some narrations never called his son, his brother Abu Abdullah by brother. He would never say brother Al Hussein, Khayyi. He would never call him by his name, by brother. And he would never call him by his name, of course. He'd only call him by Sayyidi, Mawlai, my master. This was the only thing he'd ever call his brother Imam Hussein alayhi salam by, out of respect for Abu Abdullah. Salah ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad. There's a narration that Imam Hussein alayhi salam was once sitting down and he mentioned the word, I'm thirsty. He just mentioned the word, I'm thirsty, atshan. So Abu Fadl Abbas alayhi salam runs, in the narration, he runs towards the water to fill up water and bring, to quench the thirst of his brother, Abdullah Hussein alayhi salam. He runs. So he goes and fills water for his brother and he brings it back to him. On his way back, he trips, he falls on the floor, and the water falls. And who's watching this? Imam Ali alayhi salam. Imam Ali is watching this. And he takes Abu Fadl Abbas alayhi salam on the side. He tells me, Abu Fadl. And he begins to cry. He tells me, Abu Fadl, there's gonna come a time where your brother's gonna be thirsty. And I want you to quench his thirst. It's the day of Ashura. Remember, he's going to be thirsty. And his daughters are going to be thirsty. And his sisters are going to be thirsty. Everyone's going to be thirsty. And you're the one. Anta saqil atasha. You're the one that's going to quench the thirst. Al-Fadl Abbas alayhi salam was also known for being strong, being fierce, and being beautiful. Qamar Bani Hashim. He was the light of Bani Hashim, of the tribe. He was known as being the moon of Bani Hashim. His strength, they say in some narrations, they say that Abu Fadl Abbas alayhi salam, he was so tall that if he were to sit on the horse, his feet would reach the ground. They'd have to get him a big horse. That's how tall he was, and that's how strong he was, that's how big he was. Imam Ali alayhi salam, Abu Fadl Abbas would be with Imam Ali alayhi salam in war, Abu Fadl Abbas at the age of 16, narrations, some narrations 15, some narrations 18. At that young age, he was a flag bearer, meaning he was the key to the army of Imam Ali alayhi salam. He was the key at that age. So Imam Ali alayhi salam taught Abu Fadl Abbas alayhi salam. That's that famous line where we say, La fata illa Ali wa la sayfa illa dhulfiqar. The strength of Imam Ali alayhi salam went through to Abu Fadl Abbas alayhi salam. So he was strong, he was fierce, and he was beautiful. Abu Fadl Abbas alayhi salam and all his brothers, obviously, as we all know, were all in Karbala. They were all with Imam Hussein alayhi salam, fighting by his side. But from the story of Karbala, Abu Fadl Abbas alayhi salam teaches us many things. Many things through the way he speaks about Abu Abdullah Hussein alayhi salam, the way he speaks to his sister Zainab. He teaches many, many things. But inshallah, just quickly, I'm going to touch on 3 points that he taught us. And I'm just going to give examples very briefly. I'm not going to dissect the topic, but I'm just going to go and give brief examples. He teaches teaches us many qualities. Of these qualities are 3. Number 1, loyalty. He teaches us how to be loyal. Number 2, brotherhood. He filled the meaning of brotherhood to the word. He gave the meaning to the word brotherhood. And also respect. He showed how much he respects Abu Abdullah. He shows how much he respects his older brother. For example, when it comes to loyalty, Umar ibn Sa'ad comes and he says, these sons of Umm al-Baneen, these sons of Ali ibn Abi Talib, they're scary, khutrin. We can't leave them. So, what we're going to do is we're going to try and bribe them and let them leave. So, Abu Fadl Abbas alayhi salam and his brothers. So, they go and they bring a letter from the tribe of Shimr. And this tribe apparently has a connection to the tribe of the mother of Abu Fadl Abbas alayhi salam, so Umul Bani. So they say, Yabna, ya, they go, and he's Umar ibn Sa'ad sends Shimr and a few other guys to the tent of Abu Fadl Abbas alayhi salam. And they say, Abu Fadl, if you want, you could leave. Here's a letter, and it's assuring your safety, and you're allowed to leave. You're allowed to be a free man. You and your brothers can leave. Khalas, ma alaykum shi. No one will hurt you, no one will annoy you, no one will hit you, no one, nothing. You could leave. Abu Fadl Abbas alayhi salam looks at him, takes the paper, and he rips it. And he says, أَوَلَنَا الْأَمَانُ وَلِبْنِ بِنْتِ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ لَيْسَ لَهُ أَمَانُ. And for us, leaving us and assuring us safety, but the son of Fatima Zahra alayhi salam has no safety? And you think we're going to leave Abu Abdullah al-Hussein alayhi salam? Who do you think we are? Who do you think you are? So he tells him, leave us. Show loyalty to Abu Abdullah al-Hussein alayhi salam. One might say, but he hates his brother, and why would he leave his brother and whatnot? If you know the atmosphere and the scenario that was going down on the 10th day of Ashura, you understand what loyalty was. And like we spoke a couple of days last night about the companions and how loyal they were, and about Abu Fadl Abbas alayhi salam, you're talking about 60 to 70 fighters against, in some narrations, 30,000. In some narrations, 50,000. In some narrations, 60,000. Less than 100 versus more than 20,000 people. These people had to have love, respect, and loyalty. So through the loyalty of Fadl Abbas alayhi salam, he said, no way. For example, brotherhood. Abu Fadl Abbas alayhi salam teaches us brotherhood, but through a divine scope. Meaning what? Meaning, he doesn't link brotherhood to time and space. Also, if I were to say, my brother wants me to be a good person, I'll be a good person because he told me, one. And two, I'll be extra good and extra careful when he's around me. When my brother's around me, when my friend's around me, and I claim that we have a brotherhood between each other, I'll try as hard as I can when he's next to me to try and treat him well and whatnot. Correct? When Abu Fadl Abbas alayhi salam reaches the river of Furat, he reaches it. And brothers and sisters, everyone was thirsty in Karbala. It wasn't only Sukaina was thirsty, or a few women, or Atifla Radia. Everyone was thirsty. Ali al-Akbar alayhi salam, his tongue was like a brick. Imam Hussein alayhi salam's tongue was like a brick. Everyone was thirsty. Abu Fadl Abbas was thirsty. So when he reaches the Furat, a normal human being, like for example, one of us, maybe, Allahu A'lam, would look at this water and be like, look, my brother's not next to me, and my brother's thirsty, and I'm thirsty as well, we're all thirsty. So even if I drink some water, Allah, it's not going to asr, it's not like my brother's going to az'al minni, or he's going to get cut, or he's going to... It's normal, you know? I'll drink water, he's not around, and khalas, I'll take water from him, and he'll drink, khalas, it's finished. Abu Fadl Abbas alayhi salam looks at that water, puts it up next to his mouth, and he throws it. How can I drink water and quench my thirst when my brother is thirsty? When my nieces are thirsty? Even though they're not right next to him, he doesn't link his brotherhood and his love to physical, you know, it has to be around him. No. Says, my brother is thirsty, so I will remain thirsty. And if I get back to the tents, I have water, I'll drink with them. I'm not going to drink without them. Brotherhood. And then it comes down to respect. Like we said, they never called his brother, or Khayy, or Husayn, ya Khayy, Abu Abdul, Sayyidi wa Mawlai, my master. Abu Fadl Abbas alayhi salam, on the day of Ashura, he's watching the companions go and be martyred and being chopped into pieces. He's hearing the babies scream and children cry about water and thirst. And then he looks at his nieces and nephews. And then he looks at all his mates, or his friends are going to fight. And Abu Fadl Abbas alayhi salam wants to fight. Like we said, he's a fierce warrior. when a fierce warrior, like for example, if a person, if a guy is good in FIFA, for example, if you're good at playing FIFA, or a girl's good at playing FIFA, for example, and you see people playing FIFA, the first thing you want to do is, I just want to play FIFA, I can't take it. Or someone's playing soccer, you see them playing soccer, I want to play soccer. When Abu Fadl Abbas alayhi salam sees these people going to Shahada, see these people going to war, and he's a fierce warrior, the first thing he wants to do is go to war. He wants to fight. He wants to defend Abu Abdullah alayhi salam. But out of respect for Abu Abdullah, he will never enter the battlefield. He won't even exit his tent until he gets permission from Abu Abdullah. And he always says, أتأذن لي أبا عبد الله? Do you allow me to leave you, Abu Abdullah? Do you allow me? And he says, no. And then he'd leave. Then he'd come again. Ya Abu Abdullah, do you allow me to leave? And he says, no. And then come, ya Abu Abdullah, no. So he goes and sits. Out of respect for Abu Abdullah, he doesn't make you let him say his word twice. First time he'd go, he'd say, ya Abu Abdullah, this companion just passed. Can I please go? No. Ya Abu Abdullah, go, come back. Ya Abu Abdullah, they're thirsty. No. Until it came time, push comes to shove, and he says, okay, you can go on one condition. You just ask them for water. You bring water and you come back. Don't fight. So he does exactly that. عبست وجوه القوم خوف الموت والعباس فيهم ضاحك متبسم. In a war with his brother, with Imam Ali alayhi salam, Abu Fadl Abbas alayhi salam would stand, and because of his strength, he'd stand and he'd look at him, and he's smiling. But the other side is scared of his smile because of the way, because the charisma that he's got. So it puts fear into their hearts just by them looking at him. So if Abu Fadl Abbas alayhi salam were to go and actually fight, and his intention was to fight, the story of Karbala would have been different. That's for sure. But his goal was to get water, quench thirst. So he takes the water skin and he goes to Abimah. It's narrated that al-Banin, the mother of Abu Fadl Abbas alayhi salam, brothers, dim the lights. It's narrated that al-Banin, the mother of Abu Fadl Abbas alayhi salam, the wife of Imam Ali alayhi salam, used to see that Imam Ali alayhi salam used to sit Abu Fadl Abbas in his lap. Just imagine this, yeah? Sitting in his lap. And then he'd put his sleeves up. Put his sleeves up. And he'd begin to kiss his hands and his arms. Begin to kiss them, kiss his eye, kiss his neck. And then al-Banin looks, hey, what are you doing? Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, what are you doing? And he tells us the story, he tells us what's going to happen on the day of Ashura. He tells us what will happen to Abu Abdullah, he tells us what will happen to Abu Fadl Abbas. And she begins to cry, and everyone in the room begins to cry. I say, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, you began to cry and you began to shed tears. But the hands of Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas were still attached to his body. Huh? And Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas's eyeball was still in his eye, was still in his head. Still in his socket. It was still in its rightful place. Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, I ask you, what would your reaction be on the 10th day of Ashura? When your son Abu Abdullah saw the hands of his brothers scattered on the floor. He saw his hands scattered on the floor when your daughter Zainab, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, was running from tent to tent, trying to make sure that the children don't see what they saw. Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, assalamu alaikum. Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, assalamu alaikum. يا أمير المؤمنين بكيت على ولدك العباس وانكسر قلبك ولم ترى بأم عينيك كفيه المقطوعة ولا جبينه المردود لكن سيدي
لكن ساعد الله قلبنا قلب مولانا الحسين الذي رأى كل تلك المصائب بأم عينيه يوم عاشوراء. يا أمير المؤمنين you saw أبا الفضل عباس النستي but you didn't see him on the 10th day of عاشوراء whereas أبا عبد الله الحسين had to witness the chopping of his hand, the hands of his brother بعدما بقي وحيدا لا ناصر له ولا معين. يا أمير المؤمنين إمام حسين عليه السلام was lonely, he was by himself. والأطفال تنادي العطش العطش يا أبا عبد الله. يا أمير المؤمنين the sons of Rasulullah, the daughters of Rasulullah were thirsty. They begin to cry, we're thirsty. And then Abu Fadl al-Abbas is sitting in his tent and he can't take it anymore. مولانا Abu Fadl al-Abbas لا يتحمل صرخة الأطفال. تقدم العباس من أخيه and this is the time of Abu Fadl al-Abbas comes to Imam Hussein alayhi salam ويستأذنه بالقتال. He tells him, يا أبا عبد الله, I want to go fight. وهو يرى أخوته وأبناء عمومته صرعا ويسمع بكاء النساء وعويل الأطفال وصراخهم. فألح على أخيه الحسين أن يسمح له بالبراز. He tells أبا عبد الله, I can't take it anymore. I can't hear the children anymore. I can't hear my auntie anymore. I can't hear them cry for thirst anymore. يا أبا عبد الله, please give me permission to go and fight. And then he insists. فألح على أخيه الحسين أن يسمح له بالبراز. وكان دائما يطلب الإذن من أخيه الإمام الحسين والحسن. يجيبه, يا أخي أنت صاحب اللواء, فإذا مضيت تفرق عسكري. He tells him, Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam tells Abu al-Fadl, Ya Abu al-Fadl, if you were to leave right now, you are the flag bearer of my army. He tells him, if you were to leave right now, my camp would be shattered. ولكن أمام إصرار العباس عليه السلام أجابه الإمام الحسين. Abu Fadl al-Abbas, brothers and sisters, was very persistent, very insisting. He tells his brother, Ya Abu Abdullah, I swear to you, I know, but I can't take it anymore. Wallah, the thirst of Sukaina is killing me, Ya Abu Abdullah. Abu Abdullah then tells him, fine. فَطْلُبِ الْمَالِ لِهَؤُلَاءِ الْأَطْفَالِ قَلِيلًا مِنَ الْمَالِ. He says, go, Ya Abu Fadl, but only have one go, huh? Go and ask for water. Just a bit of water. فركب العباس عليه السلام. He prepares himself. He gets on his horse. فركب العباس فرسا وأخذ القربة وقصد نحو الفرات. He takes the water skin. He puts it with him. He has his sword. He's prepared. فأحاط به من كانوا وكلين بالفرات. He goes towards the river of Furat, but there were people in charge of Furat, and they began to throw on him arrows. They began to throw arrows and spears, but he took out his sword. فحمل عليهم العباس وقتل منهم مقتلة عظيمة سقى الأرض من دمائهم. Narrations say that Abu Fadl Abbas takes his sword out, he begins to fight, he kills a large number, and the floor becomes bloody with their blood. The floor becomes to drink the blood of the enemies. ذكرهم بحملات أبيه أمير المؤمنين وفرقهم على الماء. He reminded them of his father of Amir al-Mu'mineen عليه السلام. He made them scatter from the water. ثم دخل الماء ولما أحس ببرودة الماء وشفتاه قد يبستا من العطش. And then he arrives at the river, and then he feels the coolness of the water, and his lips are crackled from thirst. ولكن كيف يشرب أخوه الحسين وكيف يشرب أخوه الحسين عطشان اخترف غرفة من الماء ولكن كيف يشرب أخوه الحسين عطشان فرمى الماء من يده. And then he looks, he takes a bit of water in his hand, and then he remembers the thirst of his brother. How can I quench my thirst and then my brother is thirsty? Brothers and sisters, he throws the water. And then he begins to say, Ya nafs man ba'd al-Husayn huni wa ba'dahu la kunti aw takuni hadha Husayn waridun manuni وتشربين باردا المعين طلّاه ما هذا فعال ديني ولا فعال صادق اليقين. ثم ملأ القربة. He takes the water skin out and he fills it with water. And then he holds it with his right hand. He puts it on his left hand. وخرج من المشاع فاستقبله الكتائب. And then he leaves towards the camp of Abu Abdullah al-Hussein to quench the thirst of Zukayna, to quench the thirst of Abu Abdullah. And then all you find is a group of enemies scatter, and they begin to put the companions of Umar ibn Sa'd create a war for Abu Fadl al-Abbas. And then Umar ibn Sa'd says, أقطعوا عليه الطريق. ثم حمل عمر بن سعد وقال ويلكم ارشقوه القرب بالنبل فوالله لئن وصل الماء إلى مخيم الحسين لأفناكم عن آخركم. عمر بن سعد says, don't you dare let Abu Fadl Abbas pass, and don't you dare let him take that water skin back to the camp of Abu Fadl of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. Wayhakum, prepare yourselves, throw every arrow you have, even if you have to finish every arrow we have to throw the arrows on that water skin. Do not let the water arrive to the camp of Imam Hussein alayhi salam, because if it were to arrive, I swear to you, not one of us will remain alive. Fatakatharu alayhi wa ahatu bihi min kulli janib. They surrounded him, men on horses, men on the ground. فحاربهم محاربة الأبطال. He fought a fierce fight. And وهو يقول لا أرهب الموت إذا الموت رقى حتى نفسي لصبط المصطفى الطهري وقال إني أنا العباس. سؤال غدوم اشتقاء ولا أخاف الشر يوم الملتقى.
He's showing the brothers and sisters that he's not scared. He's not scared. He's not scared of death. He's not scared of them. Surely he's not scared.
فكمن له أحد ومن وراء نخلة وعانه آخر.
And then one of them prepares a trap for Abu Fadl al-Abbas, and they stand behind the tree. And then another person comes to help him.
فضربوه على يمينه فبرا.
And then he cuts his right hand off.
And then Abu Fadl al-Abbas takes the sword and puts it in his left.
فأخذ السيف بشماله وهو يرتجز والله إن قطعتموه يميني إني أحامي أبدا أنا عن ديني وعن إمام صادق اليقيني نجل النبي الطاهر الأمين.
فقال حتى ضعف عن القتال فقاتل حتى ضعف عن القتال.
Brothers and sisters, he begins to fight with his left hand and then he becomes weak.
فكمن له الحكيم ابن الطفيل من وراء نخلة.
Another man stands behind a palm tree. He's hidden.
Abu Fadl al-Abbas is surrounded by hundreds of men.
And his right hand is on the floor behind him.
His left hand is holding the sword.
فضربه على شماله.
And then he hits Abu Fadl.
He hits the hand of Abu Fadl al-Abbas, what's remaining of his hand, and he cuts his left hand off.
Ya nafsu la takhshi min al-kuffari wa astabshiri bi rahmati al-jabbari qata'u bi ba. أغيهم يساري فأضلهم فأضلهم يا رب حر النار.
فحمل القربى بأسنانه. Brothers and sisters, listen to this and try and imagine this. Abu Fadl al-Abbas is on his horse, his right hand's on the floor, his left hand's on the floor, and he has one goal, huh? To take the water skin to the tent, to the camp. He wants to go, and he wants to quench the thirst of Sukayna. He wants to quench the thirst of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. But brothers and sisters, he doesn't have hands to hold the water skin anymore, huh? So he takes the water skin and he puts it between his teeth.
فحمل القرب بأسنانه وكل هم العباس أن يوصل الماء إلى المخيم.
All his goals, he has one goal in life right now, and that is to take the water skin to the مخيم, to the tent.
بينما هو كذلك جاء سهم فأصاب القربة وأريق ماواها.
Brothers and sisters, Abu Fadl al-Abbas had one goal, and that is to take the water skin to Abu Abdullah, and he has no hands anymore to fight.
And then an enemy of Allah strikes that water skin with an arrow.
Brothers and sisters, انكسر قلب العباس.
The heart of Abu Fadl al-Abbas has now been broken.
Another arrow hits the heart, the chest of Abba Fadl Abbas. وآخر وقع في عينه. And the third arrow hit his eye. وبينما العباس كذلك. Brothers and sisters, Abba Fadl Abbas right now is in a situation where his only goal is to bring water to his family. But he has no more water to bring back to his family. He has no hands to fight. He has no eyes to see. And he stands there on his horse. He doesn't know what to do. He doesn't know what's happening around him. بينما العباس كذلك لا يدان قاتل بهما ولا ما فيأتي به إلى المخيم فوقف حائرا لا يدري ما يصنع. He doesn't know what to do. وإذا بالعين جاء إليه وضربه بعمود على رأسه ففلق هامته. Brothers and sisters, he doesn't know who's coming towards him. He has no hands, his eyes gone. The blood is draining from his body, from his face. And a man comes from behind and he hits him with a spear on his head. وخر على الأرض مناديا. Brothers and sisters, Abba Fadl al-Abbas, like we said, is on the horse and he's just being struck, but he doesn't have any hands. So when he's gonna fall off the horse, how's he gonna fall, brothers and sisters? If I were to fall off the horse or you were to fall off a horse, we will land on our hands, we will protect our face. But Abba Fadl al-Abbas had no hands to protect his face. So he falls on the floor, on his head, and he is screaming, Akhi Abba Abdullah. This is the first time, brothers and sisters, that he's ever mentioned the word brother to Abba Abdullah. The first time. The first time he calls his brother by brother. Abba Abdullah. Akhi Abba Abdullah. Idrikni Abba Abdullah. فجاءه الحسين فجاءه الحسين عليه السلام ولسانه يلهج بالذكر العباس العباس العباس. Imam Hussein عليه السلام is coming towards Abba Fadl al-Abbas right now. And all he's saying right now is, Ya Abbas, Ya Abbas. ولما وصل إليه رآه صريعا على شاطئ الفرات. He saw him when he arrived to the body of Abba Fadl al-Abbas. He saw him on the floor. No hands. His head is open, his split open. He has an eye, he has an arrow in his eye. مقطوع اليدين مردود الجبين السهم نابت في العين المخ سائل على الكتفين. Brothers and sisters, listen. His brains, it's as if his brains are on his shoulders. القربان مخرقة. He looks at the wound skin and it has an arrow in it. الراية ممزقة. The flag that Abba Fadl al-Abbas was holding is now on the floor. And then Imam Hussein screams with the loudest of voices, الآن انكسر ظهري. Surely right now my back has been broken. انحنى مولانا الحسين على أخي. Imam Hussein sits down next to his brother. Brothers and sisters, if we were to see our younger brothers or our younger sisters hurt just a bit by a fly, we begin to cry, we begin to think about them, especially the mothers. How about Abu Abdullah al-Hussein when he's sitting next to his brother in this position, huh? كان به صار يمسح الدم والتراب عن وجهه. He's taking off the blood, he's wiping off the blood off the face of his brother. He's taking off the sand off the face of his brother. And it's as if I hear him say, ساعة ما وقع العباس يم الفرات وصل حسين عنده وصل حسين عنده وخنقت العبرة لكن لو تسايل وصل بيا حال أقول حسين وصل من كسر ظهره شال الراس شال الراس وبقلبه تشب نيران حط راس العزيز الغالي في حجره قال له اطلب اطلب تخير شل تريد انطيك عيني خذها مني ومالك مالك النظر اخذ عيني يا ابو فاضل حتى تتودع مني ولو أري ولو رايد بعد فدوى القطع لجفوني خذ مني ديني اليمنى واليسرى ولو ما كف ولو ما كفت اليدين واللي عيون خذ قلبي قبل المثلث يحضره ولو رايد بعد انطيق نحر الساع He tells Abba Fadl al-Abbas Imam Hussein alayhi salam tells Abba Fadl al-Abbas عندي سؤال وفكرة فيه محتار Brother, I have a question and I swear to you it's making me confused انت دايم تقل لسيدي في ليل ونهار يا خويا ما تناديني من كنا صغار بس ما طحت ناديتني يا خويا يا حسين امام حسين توزيم I want to ask you a question يا ابو فضل العباس since we were young you have never called me my brother But when you fell on the plains of Karbala, you called me Brother Hussein. Abu Fadl al-Abbas replies to him, يقل له أنا يا من عمد فوق الترب ذبني ذبني قبل ما أوصل التراب شفت إيدين جدتي يقل له اليوم العمد فوق التراب ذبني قبل ما اوصل التربان شفت ايدين اجتني He tells him before I was to fall on the ground I saw two hands come towards me a woman come towards me I didn't know who she was شفت أمك الزهرة تقول لي حلب يا ابني يا ابني I saw your mother Fatima يا أبو عبد الله telling me come towards me my son نستني آلامي وجروحي والضلع And then she reminds you, made me forget, Ya Abu Abdullah, my pains and my sorrows. She made me forget the arrow in my eye. She made me forget everything. ثم أراد الإمام الحسين عليه السلام أن يحمل العباس إلى المخيم. Imam Hussein then looks at Abu Fadl and he wants to take Abu Fadl al-Abbas to the army camp. He wants to hold his body. فقال له العباس أبو فضل العباس replies to me, tells him, إلى أين تريد يا أخي؟ My brother, where do you want to take me? Where do you want to take me? فقال له الإمام الحسين أريد أن أحملك إلى المخيم. I want to take you back to the army camp. فقال العباس أخي يا حسين بحق جدك رسول الله عليك أن لا تحملني ودعني في مكاني. He tells him, يا أبو عبد الله, I swear to you by your grandfather, I do not want you to take me to the army camp. Please don't take me to the army. Leave me where I am right now. فقال له الإمام لماذا يا أخي وكيف أتركك هنا بين الأعداء. Oh brother, how can I do that? How can I do such a thing? How can I leave you here? How can I leave you here? I need to take you back to the army camp. I need to take you to the sister. فقال له العباس أخي أبو عبد الله لأني مستحل من سكينة وقد وعدتها بالماء ولم آتيها به. He tells him, يا أبو عبد الله, I am shy from سكينة because I promised her water and I didn't bring her water. وبين الحسين عند أخيه وإذا به شقا وروح وفاضت روحه الطاهرة رحم الله من نادى وعباسا ومظلوما وسيدا. يا أبو فاضل يا أبو فاضل يا بعد عيني من رحت عيني ضاعت سنيني قومي للخيمة ورد يا أخو تريدك ايتامي وما تريد الماي بالخيام تنظر يا عباس روحت السقاي رجعت السقاي رد قلب زينب يا عباس رد قلب زينب يا أمل دنياي هذه عدواني تشمت في من راحت عني يا أخوي أبو فضل ضاعت سنيني شفت أنا بعيني للحرم لما فقام من عنده الإمام الحسين وهو يكفف ودموعه بيده ويقول الآن انكسر ظهري وقلت حيلتي وشمت بي عدوي. So أبو عبد الله الحسين raises and he gets up and he leaves and he starts to see that the tears are coming down. You begin to find that the tears are coming down as if a river is coming down, a fountain is coming down from the eyes of Imam Hussein. And he's trying to take off the tears with his hands. And as he's walking, he's saying, today is the day my back has been broken. Today is the day I have lost my brother. Today is the day my enemy becomes strong. ثم جاء الحسين إلى المخيم فرأته ابنته سكينة. Imam Hussein gets back to the camp, to the tent, and the one who sees him is سكينة. وقالت يا أبتاه أين عم بالعباس.
She tells him, "Oh father, where's my uncle Abbas? أراه قد أبطأ علينا. Look at the innocence of this child. وقد وعدنا بالماء." It's as if that he's being slow, huh? Our father, where is he? We're waiting for him. He promised us water. فعند ذلك بكى الإمام وقال لها بني بني أن عمك قد قتل. And then at that moment, Abu Abdullah al-Hussein begins to cry. He tells her, "My daughter, your uncle has been killed." فَلَمَّا سَمِعَتْ زَيْنَبْ صَرْخَ صَرَخَتْ وَنَادَتْ وَأَخَاهُ وَعَبَّاسَهُ وَأَقِلَّتْ نَاصِرَهُ وَضَيْعَتَهُ بَعْدَ Who hears him? Who hears him saying, "Our father's passed"? Sayyidah Zainab alayhi salam. And she begins to cry and she begins to call for her brother. فقال الحسين عليه السلام إي والله وضيعته بعده وانقطع ظهره وأرادت الحوراء زينب أن تذهب إلى مصر أخي العباس. Zainab wants to go to the body of Abba Fadl Abbas. فقال لها الحسين أخي sister, ارجعي, come back to me, يا زينب. لا تشمتي بنا الأعداء. قالت يا ابن أمي لا تلمني لا تلمني. إن مصاب أخي العباس قد قطعني آت قلبي ولم أستطع صبرا. زينب عليه السلام looks at Imam Hussein and Imam Hussein is telling her, "My sister, come back to me. Please don't let my enemies see you, ya Zainab." And she looks at him and replies, "Oh brother, forgive me, forgive me. But the death of Abu Fadl Abbas has broken my heart. I can't be patient when I find my brother has an arrow in his eye." يا أبو عبد الله لذلك ليلة الحادي عشر من المحرم لما توجهت زينب عليه السلام من المشرعة صارت تنادي وأخاه وعباسا. That's why you find on the 10th night of Ashura, of Muharram, Sayyidah Zainab runs towards the place where Abu Fadl Abbas was struck. And she goes to him and she's crying, "Brother, Ya Abbas." She's telling him what's going on with her. تشكو إليه مصابها. يا عباس الشفية يبدو يبول النفس الأبية تعال الحق على حسين يسلبونا أمية. آه عباسة آه عباسة آه عباسة آه عباسة آه عباسة آه عباسة. يا خويا ريحت يما ردت نحرى أشم لقيت الشمر قاعد على صدر أبو اليم. يا عباس, I went to kiss my brother Hussein and I found shimmer sitting on his chest. يا أبو فضل عباس. يا أبو فضل عباس
يقطع راس الراس 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 يا عباس يا ابو فضل عباس. He's sitting on the chest of my brother and he's cutting his head off, يا ابو فضل. انا لله وانا اليه راجعون وسيعلم الذين ظلموا آل بيت محمد بأي منقلب ينقلبون والعاقبة للمتقين. قال الله تعالى في محكم كتابه: بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، لكل الشفاء كل مريض واستجابة الدعاء وقضاء الحوائج. Let's read this five times, brothers and sisters. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. أمن يجيب المضطر إذا دعاه ويكشف السوء؟ أمن يجيب المضطر إذا دعاه مضطر إذا دعا ويكشف السوء؟ أمن يجيب المضطر إذا دعا ويكشف السوء؟